One of the things that we really always have to figure out is how do you manage that person that while you're in a conference call is making all that background noise? And so we give you lots of control to manage your participants. As you noticed, I clicked on those three participant list button up top, and now I have the ability to mute. I can remove somebody from a meeting. I can actually make somebody an attendee, which reduces their rights. But the other piece to this is if I really want to make sure that they stay, I can also choose pin to gallery. But in this case, Junmin just, you know, he was in the car or talking to somebody, making lots of noise. So I just mute him. As you can notice, his mute button is actually set in his window. And so at this point, we're not hearing any of his background noise. The other piece to this that's important is I want to make Katie an attendee. And the reason that this is important is because there's some participant actions that are important. The first one is that we bring it to you in that same heads-up display. The first one is if I wanted to mute the audience and mute everybody, that's great. Because at that point, nobody's able to interrupt me, and I just want to be able to finish my sentence without being interrupted and have my ideas taken across. But the other one is, sometimes you don't necessarily want attendees' video to be presenting. You just want the primary people. And so we also have the ability to turn off video. So in this case, we made Katie a attendee. We turn off her video. She doesn't have the ability to share video anymore with us. Now, the big one that's really probably one of the most important that we always see is you're sitting in a meeting and you're like, I need to get more people invited to this meeting. I can actually invite right from here, click invite by email. It opens up my Outlook client and I can send an email to a colleague that needs to join this meeting.